Spabs Salafi publication. Barakallahu feekum. Many people are, or they hate Spabs. Just I didn't like Spabs before. I was born with Spabs in my necklace. As Spabs. I didn't like Spabs before as well. Salafi publication. People say me they're harsh. They refute everyone. All of this nonsense. But alhamdulillah, I went. I sat with them. Wallahi, I'm not exaggerating, my brothers and sisters. These brothers, they keep it real. The way the Quran, are they perfect? They're not perfect. They make mistakes without any doubt. But don't ever compare Abdurrahman Hassan or Da'wah Man or anyone to them. These brothers, mashallah, Allah mabarak, in 30 years da'wah, they know what a salaf. They follow the salaf, not promoting salaf and opposing the salaf. Okay? No. You can see, read the books of the Salaf and listen to their speech. Listen to their talks. They don't water down the deen. They don't water down the deen. Alhamdulillah. Listen to them, alhamdulillah. Old in age. Experience, alhamdulillah. Read Abu Iyad's works. Abu Khadija's works. They say, akhi, he doesn't know how to speak Arabic. لا يعرف كيف يتكلم اللغة العربية. Did you know, akhi al-Kareem, كان كما ذكر الذهبي رحمه الله تعالى في سير اعلام النبلاء كثير من ائمه ليس كثير ذكر بعض العلماء من ائمه الاسلام من ائمه الاسلام كان عندهم لحن في اللغه العربيه وفي القران they used to make mistakes in Arabic language. Imam al-Dhahabi mentioned there were some Arabic Muslim scholars, Islamic scholars of the past, okay, great scholars, imams. They used to make mistakes in Arabic language. And they used to make mistakes in recitation of the Quran. But he said, they were still imams. And it is not condition. أنا أرد على عبد الرحمن حسن هذا المميع. هذا ليس شرط لكي ترد على شخص لابد أن تعرف اللغة العربية الفصحى. ليس شرط. ليس شرط أن تكون كامل أو تكون من علماء اللغة العربية كسيبويه أو كابن الفارس بارك الله فيكم. هذا is no condition. وكذلك ليس شرط أن تكون من علماء القرآن أو من القراء الذين يعرفوا قراءة العشر لكي ترد على المبتدع. هذا ليس شرط. هذه شروط أهل التمييع. This is a response to our brother Abdurrahman Hassan. May Allah guide him when he's trying to water down about refutation. It is not a condition to refute someone. You have to be a scholar in Arabic language. You have to be like Sibawayh or Ibn Faris. Or you have to be a scholar in the Quran or the Qira'at, different recitations. These conditions is to stop people of the truth to expose people of falsehood. No, you cannot refute. If you know, you don't know Arabic language, no, you cannot refute. And I'm not saying just everyone refute. Yes, there is some conditions that you have to know the truth. And you have to know what is calling to is falsehood. If someone in the city knows and is student of knowledge, then you go and tell him, listen, akhi, this person said such and such. Please respond to him. Barakallahu feek. But imagine I live in a village and there is someone pushing misguidance and I don't know Arabic language, but alhamdulillah I study Thadha Usul, I study Usul Sunnah Imam Ahmad Hanbal, Sunnah Imam Muzani, Shah Sunnah Imam Barbahari, I read experiential scholars and I know where he's calling to is misguidance. So what I have to do? I have to learn Ibn Faris, Maqayis al-Lugha, and Sibawayh, and what they call it, Lisan al-Arab al-Mandur. And Qira'at al-Ash before? No. Be aware. This brother, may Allah guide him, clearly pushing. And alhamdulillah, this brother has been refuted by Abu Iyad and Abu Khadija, Abu al-Hamami. Barakallahu feekum. And we don't, please, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us and guide him without any doubt. But many videos people are sending it to me that clearly he's pushing Tamiyyah. watering down the principles of Al-Sunnah wal-Jama'ah. Barakallahu feekum. So if people ask me about him, stick to Abu Iyad, Abu Khadija, Abdul Ejal Hamami, Musa Richardson, Anwar Wright, you have Hassan al-Somali. These brothers, may Allah bless you, my brothers and sisters, they be open to da'wah salafiyya when some of us were not even born. Barakallahu feekum. And alhamdulillah, by Allah's tawfiq, every time they refute someone, later on, everything will become clear. For example, my brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. When they spoke out and guessed, yes, Al-Qadi, you know how long ago? And that one man thought he was the first person to speak about. Bro, when Abu Iyad, Abu Khadija spoke about him, I think he was in primary school or something. You understand? Like, you know, give people their rights. You know, give people their rights. You cannot just make claim. Yesterday, when you're talking to a post, today say, I'm the first person to refute. It's not about first anyway. It's not about first. But to understand these brothers, they be upon the haqq, alhamdulillah, for a long time. When people lie about them, people just accuse them. They work for Saudi. They got money from the government. Go ahead. They challenge people, show us one proof where we got money from the government. This guy who lied and gassed them, he said they took 1 million from the government. The challenge is still on for 2 years. This kadab, he has not brought no proofs. Barakallah, you come up, brothers and sisters. So we are in the middle. We refute the atheist. We refute the liberalism. We refute Islam haters. Likewise, we refute the people of innovation misguidance. But there is a way. From the layman, you be nice to them, be good to them. They don't know, talk to them nicely. But if someone's stubborn and clearly is upon misguidance and waging a war and gets Ahl-Sunnah, then speak out. Barakallahu feekum. Anyway, they spoke about Yasser Qadi or Yasser al-Fadi in the 2000, 20 years ago. Some of us maybe weren't even born. Barakallahu feekum. 20 years ago, they spoke out against Yasser Qadi. Now Yasser Qadi, what is doing? Yasser Qadi, may Allah guide us and guide him, and may Allah save us doubts and misconceptions. He's been used by the Orientalists as a trumpet to push doubt against Islam. May Allah bless you. So a Salaf publication, alhamdulillah, our brothers, our teachers, you know, alhamdulillah, they have a love for the deen. And they won't, and guess, sitting down and debating with innovations, you know, misguidance, organizing. That's why when someone asked me, say, how come you refuted, you know, the scholars have refuted, and you promoting the refutation, and guess, Abdulrahman Hassan, when you refute Abu al-Bara al-Khariji, but you, Shamsi, go speaker's corner. I said, brother, it's not the same. Speaker's corner does not belong to no one. Speaker's corner is the platform to give da'wah. Alhamdulillah, many people accept Islam there. Alhamdulillah, many people accept Salafiyya there. Yes, sometimes people come and try debate for the sake of debating. And the people that try to challenge me, then according to the book of Salaf, that if you dare and you think spreading doubt, there's conditions to it. But as for organizing it, sitting with him, smiling with him, you know, joking, all of that is not the way of the Salaf. Barakallahu feekum. That is not the way of the Salaf, because sometimes the person, you just promote on him, you know, promoting the person. Barakallahu feekum.